Welcome back. In the last video, we started setting up the game mode, HUD, and the power to win. And in this video, we're going to start actually setting up the blueprint for the HUD and the progress bar so we can start displaying the character's power relative to the power needed to win. Really quick though, I realized after the last video I hit compile and it didn't succeed, we actually need to define get power to win. So let's go ahead and switch over to the game mode for the battery collector, or sorry, the source file for the game mode, and just put that in there really quick because we do need it for the HUD. And get power to win. And that's just going to return power to win. And see, this one has const. You don't necessarily have to have that when you're working with these getters, but if you just want to super enforce that you can't change your power to win in the course of the function, you can use that there. It's just another example that we wanted to show. Okay, so now when I switch to the editor and compile, we should have success. Just gonna let that run, and then we're gonna start making our game mode blueprint and our widget blueprint. So we can go ahead and switch the blueprints folder while we're waiting for that compilation to happen. Ah! I accidentally typed void on right there. I'm just so used to, I was looking up at tick, this is a float because it's got to return a float. So we'll go back and compile one more time. And we can actually start working on our HUD while that's going. So if you right click in the content browser, we will create a new user interface widget blueprint. And there was that successful compile right there. And we're gonna call this battery HUD. And then wonder why Visual Studio is poking its head up to the front of that window. Okay. So we'll save that, go ahead and open it. And we're going to need a progress bar. So here in the palette, you can grab the progress bar and drag it over. And if UMG, if it's something you haven't really started to work with yet and you'd like to start with a more basic tutorial, we have some of those online in written form, which you could totally jump to, you know, pause the video, figure that out, and then come back. Because it is something that I'm going to be going through sort of in a quick sense here. So we're going to set the anchor to the center of the window, and we're going to adjust the position for X to 0, and Y will make negative 100 seems good, sort of a little bit offset from the bottom there. We'll make the bar quite a bit wider, we'll make it 600. And then we want to shift it a little bit to the left, or actually center it, so we'll make the alignment X 0.5. So that means half of it's here on the left, half of it's here on the right. Now to fill in the percentage, we're going to create a binding. So right here under progress, percent, there's this bind dropdown. We're going to click on that and create binding. We're gonna move these apart for a little bit to give ourselves some room to work. And then I'll go ahead and break that that connection with alt click. So what we want is we're going to have the progress bar be some percentage of the player character's power level, current power, over the game mode's power to win. So let's go ahead and get the player character. So right click, get player character in the context menu here. And we want to make sure we cast this to our battery collector character because that's the only one that has that power level on it. And we can actually right click on this and make it into a pure cast. Because I happen to know as we're working on this project that we're only going to have the one character and the one game mode. But if you're going to switch characters or something, you should make sure that you use execution pins to only wire those up when they're successful. And then we'll go ahead and right click, context menu again, and get the game mode. Again, we're going to cast this to our battery collector game mode. And we can do that convert to a pure cast again. And that just is to clean up some of the execution wires. But you do have to be aware that you have to be sure that these are both true. In fact, we could multiply these. Eh. Actually, we could just put these back on impure cast if we wanted to wire them up in sequence, but I'm going to trust that I've got those both set up correctly. So now I've got the battery collector character, and we're going to get the current power, because that's that function we set up previously that was that public accessor function. And then from the game mode, we're going to get power to win. So when we have both of those, we can divide current power by the power to win and use that as the percentage for our power bar. And then we can should wire those back up. I think if you did want to keep these as impure cast, you could wire them up in line. So now to actually use the HUD, we need to go create a game mode blueprint. Again, right here, right click and create a new blueprint. And we've got this drop down, and we can put in our battery collector game mode and select that. And we're just going to name this game mode BP. Kind of that same naming scheme that we had for our pickups and our batteries. So we'll go ahead and open that. And if you notice, we have the HUD widget class. That's that variable that we just set up in the last video. And we can make that battery HUD and compile and save. Now, don't just start playing right now, because the one thing is, we have to now tell our level to use the game mode blueprint as our default game mode. And you can do that either per level, or we want to do it in the project settings. So we'll go to settings up here in the main toolbar, and then project settings, maps and modes. And then here our default game mode, we will just switch that to game mode BP. And that will automatically save in our configuration file. So now if we hit play, we've got our progress bar. You can see it ticking down because that game mode is draining our power. But then if I collect some batteries, it will fill up the bar. And because we don't have any sort of state for what to do when you've got more power than power to win, the game will end yet, but you can see the power bar is actually probably over full at this point. Okay, so in the next video, we're actually going to start working on that game over, game one kind of states. And thanks for listening.